Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Poets and Quants' Must Reads, your quick digestible recap of the top business school news, sponsored by Center Court, our virtual admission events. I'm your host, Christy Bleiseffer, and I'll be highlighting the most important P&Q stories you might have missed. So let's get to it. Number one, the M7 by the numbers. In two short application cycles, in 21 and 2022, M7 acceptance rate jumped 34% and yield dropped 10%. Is this the start of an era of greater accessibility at the most elite business schools in the US, or the tail end of a short window? This story dives deep into the data to capture M7 admission trends you won't find anywhere else, not only on admission and yield rates, but on class size, tuition, cost, pay, placement, and more. You'll find it all on our homepage. Number two, an MBA candidate's roadmap to becoming CEO. In his personal essay, Rohit Gupta maps out his game plan for going from an MBA candidate at IMD Business School in Switzerland to a CEO at a large company. The finance and accounting professional has professional experience in several industries and across several disciplines. His essay lays out the steps needed before, during, and after an MBA to land at the head of the C-suite. You can find his essay in our trending tab. Number three, strong MBA hiring forecast in new GMAC survey of recruiters. For MBA students, it's easy to get lost in the struggles when contemplating the hiring landscape you will graduate into. But overall, it continues to be good to have an MBA in today's market. That's the takeaway from the Graduate Management Admission Council's annual survey of employers. It finds that widespread economic concerns haven't dampened recruiters' enthusiasm for graduates of global MBA programs. Rather, the survey shows that employer confidence in business schools' ability to prepare grads to be successful in their organizations has risen to new heights. That is especially true in light of the rise of the artificial intelligence, which has thrown into sharp relief the value of the kind of human skills that B schools can hone. Read the full survey results in our news tab. Number four, our weekly roundup of news you can use. No matter where you are in your MBA journey, we bring several helpful stories to you this week. First up, how to ace the HBS essay. Harvard Business School changed its essay question for the first time in a decade. A former HBS insider explains what the school is really looking for in its applicant essays. You can find the story on our homepage. Next, Duke Fuqua to end open interview period for applicants. This story, in our admissions hub, explains why the B School is going to an invitation-only model for this fall's admissions cycle. And finally, Stanford GSB application essays and advice. This story, in our admissions hub, also offered tips for nailing essays at Virginia Darden and London Business School. And that's it for this week's Must Reads recap. I also want to alert school seekers to our events tab from our main menu. There you'll find all the upcoming admission events for a range of degrees and programs, including full-time and online MBAs, specialized masters, entrepreneurship, and more. Registration is free. Again, I'm Christy Bleiseffer, and you can join me next week right here for a recap of what's important in the world of business education. Thanks for listening.